Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to quickly show you how you can use an audio file to affect scale or location of an object in Blender. So to briefly show you the test file that I made, here it is. And you can see that the objects in the middle are basically scaling up and down based on the amplitude of the sound. And I've actually delayed one of them relative to the other, which is why they don't go up and down together. But other than that, they're both based on the same audio file, and then the camera is just moving around in the environment. So to show you what that looks like in the 3D viewport, you can hear the sound playing while it scans through. This little bit here is the graph editor, which we'll get to in a moment, and you can see the objects jumping up in scale as we go through the video. Pretty straightforward, but we'll start again from scratch. The rest of this is just sort of patterning and decoration that I created, and this is the track for the camera. We'll create a new file and we'll add an object. We'll make it a UV sphere so it's nice and simple. We'll apply rotation and scale, we'll go to smooth shading, and let's just give it a basic color. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to add a keyframe from which the F curve, which is where the sound comes from, starts. So if we decide we're going to, in this case, well, let's move the object. So we'll go to the object properties and we will press I while hovering over location. So that's now got a keyframe at frame one to say this is where the object is. And if I move the object somewhere else and then start playing, you can see it jumps back to there. Now that we've got a keyframe, we can load our audio file in and bake the amplitude of the audio into a graph which will affect the location. And obviously I could affect just one of the locations, but we'll go to the graph editor, which is just here. And then what we say is key bake sound to F curve. So it now is asking me where I want to find the sound. And we'll go with this one. So that's now loaded a sound in. And you can see it's created a curve based on the overall amplitude of that sound. And if we now press play, we can't hear it at the moment because all it has done is baked the sound into there. We haven't loaded the sound into Blender as such. So what we now need to do is if we go to the video sequence editor, make sure we're at frame one, and add a sound, and we add the same sound. And now when we press play, you can see the music is, you can hear that the music is now audible. So if you now go back to our 3D view, and we can see our object is actually moving based on the amplitude of that sound. So if I bring up another window, we'll put it about there, and we'll set that window to the graph editor. I'll make it a little bigger. You can see that the object moves based on height of those little peaks in there. And essentially, that's all there is to making an object move or rescale or rotate. We could just as easily, for example, add a cube, scale it on the x-axis, push it back a little bit, we'll give it a different color. And what we'll do this time is we'll alter its rotation. So we'll go to the object properties. What I'm doing at the moment is I'm affecting all of the rotations. It's perfectly possible just to affect one of them. What we'll do, in fact, we'll put the keyframe, instead of at frame one, we'll put the keyframe five frames later. So this is now at frame five. And we'll add a keyframe for rotation. And then we'll come to our graph editor and we will say key bake sound to F curves, and we'll use the same one again. You can see we've got a file there, and you can see there's a slight delay in the reaction of the rectangle to the sound, and that's because I delayed it by five frames. That's really all there is to baking sound to F curves. I just added a few other interesting things in the background, added a track for the camera based upon a Bezier circle, and using a circle means it goes obviously in a complete circle, and if you want to you can make it go around several times very smoothly and then just drag some of the points of the circle in. So I hope you found that useful. If you did, let me know. I may have time to do another short tutorial this weekend, and if you enjoyed it, let me know in the comments below. If you've got any suggestions, just let me know. I read them all and try to answer most of them. Thanks a lot.